years, I've had the privilege of playing with a lot of young kids who are being raised here, and they're learning Indian classical music or Rabindranath. And I remember quite a few of them. One of them is Ishita Ganguly, who learned from Shuchitra Mitra. She's pretty close to my age, 1990-91, I played with her. Then I played with Shahri Nabedin, and she used to sing Lalan Mungiti. This was in the late 90s. Very good job in that. And then Rimi, I played with her quite a bit, who's amazing. And then finally Ritika. These are the four that I could remember. Now you have to understand, if you have ever been exposed to Indian classical music, how difficult it is to sustain your interest in it and your practice in it, and to achieve a level of competence that makes other people feel that you have touched the notes. We are extremely critical. People who have been playing in this area or who have been exposed to this music, we always find a fault or two, because we say, okay, this is where the sa has not been touched, or this is where the tune has slipped, or this is where the rhythm has slipped a little bit. So we are very critical of that. I was amazed to see how Ritika was so serious about it, that every time there was a concert where we had the privilege of listening to a master in this area. Thank you. In this area, whenever we had a master, even if there were four or five people in the audience, and as of 3 weeks ago, that's exactly what was going on, right, Ritika? She was the one who was sitting in the front, Shantanu Bandyopadhyay from one of the best gharanas of India, which is Vishnupur Gharana, who was here. He was playing and I was accompanying him. Ritika was there in the front. And what I was observing is that when everyone sings or performs, she was absorbing from that master what the best talents of that particular gharana was. This is a talent that does not come easy. It comes with extremely dedicated cultural practice in a home, thanks to Kaushik and Anjali. And then it comes from gurus, and then it comes from the person's own maturity level and appreciation of what is exactly going on. If someone puts me in front of a Korean classical music concert and says, go and enjoy it, I know that I will be a little bored, right? Many of us did not have the privilege of actually getting such exposure. Some of us did, others did not. But to actually be thrown in that kind of a pool and then learning from that and then absorbing it and making it a part of their life, it is extremely difficult. I just wanted you to appreciate that what Ritika has done is almost next to impossible. So let's give her a big hand.